Have you ever been to the magic room of an amusement park? In that room, you will find that there are many mirrors that are placed with different angles in between them. If you stand in between those mirrors, you will find that multiple images of you are being formed. So why do you think that keeping two mirrors or more number of mirrors at different angles, we are able to form these multiple images? Let us find out. You can try a very simple experiment at home. What you will do is, you'll take two mirrors, M1 and M2, and place them at an angle of theta degrees. This is a simplified version of what we see in magic rooms. Now, when you keep them at an angle of theta degrees and place an object in between them, you will see that you're able to see a number of images being formed on M1 and M2. Now, if you change the angle in between M1 and M2, that is, if you change theta, you will see that the number of images formed are different. So, what do you think is determining the number of images? This is actually determined by a very simple formula. The number of images that we are seeing, or n, is given by a very simple formula. That is 360 by theta or 360 by theta minus 1. Here, theta is the angle that is being formed in between the two mirrors. Now, why do we have two formulae for the number of images? Always note and remember that n should be an odd integer. Now, depending on the value we obtain from these two formulae, we have to choose that value of n which is an odd integer. This is the reason why we have two formulae. Now, to verify this formula, you can perform another simple experiment. Take two plane mirrors and keep them at an angle of 90 degrees, that is perpendicular to one another. Place a small object, for example, a candle, in between these two mirrors. You will find that you can see three images of this candle on the mirrors. Now let us find out and try to verify the formula that we obtained in the previous case. The formula was 360 by theta or 360 by theta minus 1. And in this experiment, we have kept the mirrors at an angle of 90 degrees. So the value of theta is 90. Now, if we put the value of theta in these two formulae, we obtain the value of n as 360 by 90, which comes out to be 4, or 360 by 90 minus 1, that comes out to be 3. So, the number of images n is coming out to be 4 or 3. Now, what did I say about the value of n? N should always be an odd integer. So, among 4 and 3, which one is an odd integer? 3. So, the number of images being formed is 3. Does this verify the formula? Yes. Because, as you will recall, when we performed the mirror experiment, we obtained three images, and when we verified the formula with the same, we find that n is coming out to be 3. So the formula holds true. Now, let us find out how the multiple images are being formed with the help of a ray diagram. Here, P denotes the object that is placed in between two perpendicular mirrors, M1 and M2. The rays of light that are incident from P on M2 after reflection are incident on M1. This forms image P1. Now, after reflection, the light that is incident on M1 gets reflected again, and an image P2 is formed. So, we can say that P1 is the virtual object for P2. Now, if we consider light rays which is shown by the white rays falling on mirror M1, you will find that after reflection, they are hitting mirror M2. Now, due to this, an image P3 is being formed. This image P3 is acting as the virtual object for image P4. P4 is being formed due to reflection of the light rays from mirror M2 after reflection from M1. Now you will notice that two images are overlapping, that is image P2 and image P4. Also, when you perform the candle experiment with two perpendicular mirrors, you will notice that one of the images is brighter than the other two. This is explained by the overlapping of the two images, in this case P2 and P4. So taking a quick recap, what did we learn? We learned that multiple images of an object can be obtained if we place two mirrors at an angle of theta. This angle theta, when varied, gives rise to a different number of images. The number of images can be determined by a very simple formula. The formula was 360 by theta or 360 by theta minus 1. Why are we using two formulae? These two formulae are being used because the result or the number of images should always be an odd integer. So depending on the values we obtain from these two formulae, the number of images or n should always be equal to an odd integer. We also verified the same by performing a simple experiment by keeping two mirrors at an angle of 90 degrees. We found that we obtained three images. We also found that one of the images was brighter than the other two. This happened because two images, in this case P2 and P4, overlapped with one another.